Hi, welcome you all to the next session of advanced accounting of your second advanced accounting of TYBCom. In this session we will be dealing with illustration number 6 of page number 42 of your textbook, that is Nirali Prakashan. Am I clear to it? Okay, now we'll go further with the solution part of it. First I'll read the question for you all, then we'll mark the necessary things what we wanted to take out, and then we'll put that information into the solution so that we can get a proper answer for that. And my dear students, this is the second part of your chapter number 2, that is insurance claim. In insurance claim we have two practical aspects. Any one of the aspect can be asked by your university. First one was loss of policy, loss of stock, and second one was loss of profit. In both the situation you are required to calculate the amount of claim to be lost to the insurance company for calculation. Am I clear to it? Okay, for first session, for first problem and for first method we have completed 10 problems. Please go through it and solve it, because the chapter is for 8 mark in your university exam and the problems are very simple. Once you understand the concept, there is nothing to be worried of. And second one, this is the sixth problem, second method, this is the sixth problem what we are dealing today, and I will be dealing with one more problem of this session, this type, and then we will be winding up with this chapter, and then we will be moving on to the next chapter of your syllabus. Am I clear to it? Okay, chalo, we'll start with Akash Traders Ahmednagar are insured under a loss of profit policy for 1,60,000. The books of accounts are closed on 31st December each year. The fire occurred in the premises of the business on 1st 7 2015. The records saved disclose the following information. Fire has occurred on 1st July 2015. ठीक है, ओके. देन 2014 विल बी आर प्रीवियस ईयर, 2015 विल बी आर करंट ईयर. क्लियर टू इट? ओके. नाउ रिकॉर्ड टर्नओवर ड्यूरिंग द ईयर एंडेड 30/6/2015 इज 14,40,000. नेक्स्ट टर्नओवर ड्यूरिंग द ईयर एंडेड 31/12/2014, दैट मीन्स दिस इज आर प्रीवियस ईयर टर्नओवर 12 lakhs. Then we have turnover from 1st 7 2015 to 31st 9 2015, that is 60,000, that is dislocation period sales. Next we have turnover in the corresponding period for 2014 is 3,60,000, that is corresponding periods turnover. Then we have standing charges, then we have net profit, that is 48,000. It has been ascertained that business has constantly shown an increase of 25% in the turnover in the month preceding the fire over corresponding period for the previous year. That means हमारे पास upward trend दिया है 25% का. For this upward trend we have to, while we are calculating short sales, तो शॉर्ट सेल्स में जो हम करस्पॉन्डिंग पीरियड के अमाउंट लेते हैं, दैट अमाउंट हैज़ टू बी इंक्रीज बाय 25%, बिकॉज एज दे हैव गिवन अस द 25% का ट्रेंड. क्लियर टू इट? ओके, आई विल सॉल्व. फर्स्ट स्टेप टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम इज टू फाइंड आउट द शॉर्ट सेल्स, एंड यू नो द शॉर्ट सेल्स का जो फॉर्मूला है, द शॉर्ट सेल का फॉर्मूला क्या है? करस्पॉन्डिंग पीरियड turnover minus dislocation period turnover. Once you minus corresponding period turnover with the dislocation period turnover, the amount what you will get is the short sales. ठीक है, तो चलो, but we have 25% turnover, that is upward increase. तो what to do with that, we'll see. कैलकुलेशन ऑफ शॉर्ट सेल्स, एक्सपेक्टेड टर्न ओवर फॉर द करस्पॉन्डिंग पीरियड. ये एक्सपेक्टेड टर्न ओवर क्या चीज़ का है? करस्पॉन्डिंग पीरियड्स टर्न ओवर. लेट सी वॉट इज द करस्पॉन्डिंग पीरियड टर्न ओवर, दैट इज 3,60,000. but as they have given us 25% increase of turnover, what we'll do, we'll add it up 25% here. 25 upon 100, kis cheez ka? 3 lakh iska, 60,000. 3,60,000 का 25% is 90,000. You have to add it up. 3,60,000 plus 90,000, you will get 4,50,000. This is the amount of corresponding period of turnover. From this, you have to less dislocation period sales. See, I have marked it here, that is 60,000. Dislocation period sales is 60,000. Less actual turnover during the indemnity period, which is called as dislocation period, that is 60,000. 4,50,000 minus 60,000, that is 3,90,000. This 3,90,000 is nothing but your short sales. First step completed. Now the second step is that to calculate the gross profit ratio. And to calculate the gross profit ratio under loss of policy method, the formula is net profit during the year, previous accounting year, plus in short standing charges in the previous accounting year, divided by sales in the last accounting year into 100. What they have said, net profit for the previous year. See, they have given net profit for the previous year is 48,000. What they have said, standing in short charges. In short charges is 72,000. 72,000. Sales in the last accounting year. Last accounting year ka sales kitna hai? Wo unhone diya hai. That is 12 lakhs. That is 12 lakhs into 100. Now, add it up, 48,000 plus 72,000. 48,000 plus 72,000 will give you 0, 1, 8, 12, 1,20,000. 1,20,000 divided by 12 lakh into 100 will give you 10%. This 10% is nothing but your gross profit. This was the second step. Now the third step to calculate is to calculate the loss of profit on sales. Loss of profit on sales, the formula is gross profit ratio into short sales. What is the gross profit ratio here? 10%. And what is the amount of short sales what we got? That is 3,90,000. 10% of 3,90,000 will give you 39,000. 39,000 is nothing but your loss of profit on sales. This is the third step. Fourth step is application of average clause. Now, application of average clause. Before calculating or before applying the average clause formula, you need to calculate how much amount is of insurance coverage. Insurance coverage required. Kitna insurance coverage hai? That is 10% of sales year ending to the fire. A fire ka jo year ending tha, fire hui thi 1st 7 2015 को, और ईयर एंड हुआ है 36 2015, दैट इज 14,40,000. 10% ऑफ 14,40,000 प्लस 25% इंक्रीज. 14,40,000 का 25% इंक्रीज विल बी 36,000. एडेड अप 36,000 इंटू 14,40,000, द टोटल विल बी 18 lakhs, एंड टेक द 10% ऑफ दैट, द अमाउंट इज 1,80,000 विच इज बीन कवर्ड अंडर इंश्योरेंस. नाउ calculate the amount of claim under average clause. Amount of insurance policy taken divided by insurance covered into gross claim. Amount of insurance policy they have given, see, 1,26,000. 1,26,000. Insurance covered required, that is 1,80,000, into gross claim, that is 39,000 claim. 39,000, the answer is 27,300. And this is the amount of claim to be lodged with the insurance company. In case if there is no average clause, this would have been the amount, 39,000. Or agar insurance policy jo aapne nikala hai and loss is more than the insurance policy. Now see, hamara policy hai 1,26,000 ka, theek hai, aur hamara loss hua hai 39,000 ka. When loss is less than the policy amount, then you can calculate the average clause policy. You can take the average clause policy method. If the loss is more than the policy, the सॉरी इफ द लॉस इज लेस देन द पॉलिसी देन अप्लाई एवरेज क्लॉज का फॉर्मूला. इफ लॉस इज मोर देन द इफ लॉस इज मोर देन द पॉलिसी देन यू हैव टू टेक दिस अमाउंट दैट ग्रॉस लॉस ऑफ प्रॉफिट ऑन सेल्स एज योर अमाउंट ऑफ इंश्योरेंस कंपनी टू बी क्लेम्ड ऑफ. क्लियर टू इट. एवरेज क्लॉज का कब कब एप्लीकेशन होगा? वन आपके पास कब कब एप्लीकेशन होगा? वन जब आपके पास पॉलिसी की अमाउंट दी है, एज जैसे कि ये प्रॉब्लम है 1,26,000 दिया था. सेकेंड सिचुएशन जब आपका लॉस इज मोर देन द इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी देन यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द अमाउंट अंडर एवरेज क्लॉज. If your loss is less than the average is less than the policy taken and if there is no average clause then this amount is applied for forwarding to the insurance company for getting the claim. Clear to it? Okay. The problem is very easy. Just here the new concept is 25% upward trend. This 25% you have to adjust 1 year in the corresponding sales that you have to take, because 25% extra of the corresponding amount and you have to add it up to the corresponding. And second, this 25% will be applied under insurance coverage where we calculate how much amount is covered under insurance. So what we'll do, we'll take the sales amount year ending to the fire and we'll add it up 25% of that into that amount. That is 14,40,000 mein hum 25% add karenge, that is 3,60,000 aur ye dono ko jab hum add karenge we'll get 18 lakhs aur is 18 lakhs ka hame 10% jo gross profit hai wo nikalna hai. To ye jo amount aayegi 1,80,000 that is your amount of insurance covered. Clear to it? Okay, chalo. Then apply the formula of average clause and put it up the value accordingly, like amount of insurance policy 1,26,000, insurance covered that is 1,80,000 and gross claim. Hum isko bol sakte loss of profit. Kitna hua hai hamara loss of profit? That is 3,39,000. 1,26,000 divided by 1,80,000 into 39,000, the amount will be 27,300. This is the amount claimed with the insurance company. Thank you all. Please go through the problem and pin me if you have any doubt. We'll solve one more problem of this and then we'll wind up with this chapter. Thank you all. Thank you.